Oh, my pretty girl.
Yeah. Wanna go get the bird? Get the bird. Get the bird, girl. Yeah, get the bird.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Rasmussen Outdoors, RODTV for short. I need to start this video off. This is our first episode of our new channel, and I already need to start this video off with an apology because at the time of me filming this introduction video, I had already filmed all my hunting videos for the year. But I had noticed that somewhere along the line, I had lost my first original introduction video. So we're redoing it now. This is the best year I've had deer hunting by far. I had 3 bucks this year, 2 that were really nice, and then 1 that was a little smaller that I had shot first. And I need to apologize again because I did not get that one on film, but I did get the other 2 on film. So with that being said, viewer discretion is advised. This is an outdoors channel. This is a hunting channel. So you will see animals being hunted. So viewer discretion is advised. One more thing I need to add before we get into the video is I didn't notice this until we got to editing, but my GoPro, the date on there says like January 2018 or something like that. So the date on there is wrong. It is November of 2023. So that is when all this was filmed. With that being said, I hope you enjoy this video and stick around because there are several more videos to come. Please enjoy this video of our 2023 deer shotgun season. Alright, so we had a couple of fawns come through this morning, as you guys can see. It's about 9:30, and the deer have kind of stopped moving for the time being. We're going to go do a little pushing now, and we're going to come back to this same spot in the evening. And we're going to try and get here before the other guys get to their spots, because the way they walk in, you know, whatever they push out usually should come down to where I'm sitting. Heard a lot of shooting around the area. We're gonna go see if some of those other guys got any success in their spot. Been a lot of deer movement so far this morning, so we're gonna go do some pushing now, and it should hopefully be we should get some action. We should see some deer moving. And we're gonna go hit some spots now that hopefully have not been hit yet. So stay tuned, and we will be back with you.
little bit beaten down here. A lot of tracks I can see. Trail cam set up right there. Around 7 this morning.
I did, however, like within the first 5 minutes of me sitting down, like we're sitting there talking about mountain lions and shit, I'm like shit my pants because I just kind of was like sitting there and I look over and a fucking coyote. I kid you not, it's probably from me to your broken mirror away. It just came trudging downhill. I had no idea I was even there. It made my heart skip a beat because, like I said, we kept talking about mountain lions last night.
One, I had a load of turkeys again. Bunch of squirrels, the usual.
I didn't see a squirrel. The only thing I saw were just birds and that coyote. I heard turkeys, I didn't even see them.
Walker, get to where you're in the middle, so if you don't want on this side, it's like on that edge of this stuff, it's cold. It's facing that way.
Oh, you guys are going to walk it this way?
I don't care which way we push it. The deer are going to come out. They're either going to go that way or this way.
You want me on the far end closest to that road?
This path you just walked, gets like on that edge of it, in the middle.
In the middle, okay.
It's like this over here. Does that make sense?
I think so.
We're pushing that, right? They're going to come this way. So you're going to be on that outside edge of that patch, right? We're just gonna push it and let them run out the open for a while, not be so tight to the girls.
Okay.
So go ahead and get set. I already got Cody on the end of the girl over on a patch. And then I think Brandon.
Yep.
You and I will probably walk it. I can walk the middle.
Okay.
And you just get about 100 yards ahead of me on the outside edge over here.
On that farther edge or on this edge? Okay.
Walker's gonna have this side covered in theory.
Okay. That'll work.
Alright, go ahead, Walker. Go.
Alrighty. This patch and that tall grass on that side, that's where you're going.
In this?
Yeah, this.
Oh. We just hit this, Walker.
Yes, I know.
Okay, so this thing, if that thing is my hand, right? It's like this. We pushed it this way, right? You're gonna walk out into the following to this side of it. That side is east. You're gonna be on the east side of that thing.
I got it now.
In the middle.
No, man.
I got it.
It's like talking to a goddamn wall.
Hear
me at him again, I'll you.
Well, I don't know how that could have been. Look at what we're going to push. Where did the deer run yesterday? Go sit right in there.
You try and you try.
So what?
There's two to choose from. Unbelievable. Holy. I'm gonna guess probably where they're gonna go.
Go sit right in the middle.
Holy fuck. What a goddamn show.
So yeah, I think
they might run for that corn again, so yeah. Tony there.
Tony?
Yeah. We have him get up the middle of that bastard.
Good.
Send his ass up the middle.
Well, and then we could get a guy on the side, like along the ditch.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's not a bad idea either.
Maybe I'll go post somewhere along that side ditch.
Okay.
Where I think. And you two work out who's going to walk up the middle and about 100 yards ahead up that side.
Okay. That'll work.
I'll tell him to talk to you.
Okay. Well, I have a feeling I'm going up the middle on this one. If you want to,
yeah.
I'll be on.
Are you the only guy walking?
I think so. I'll be on that farther edge of it because I think they're gonna head. There's some corn over on that side. I think they're gonna head for.
Where's Vern going?
Vern's going. I think he's gonna post a ditch on that other side, on that east side of it. So.
Well, I'll just wait here for like 5 or 10 minutes, and then I'll go.
Okay.
You don't need a lot of time, do you?
No. Yeah. No. I'll just be about probably 100 yards in front of you on that other east side of it. So.
Okay, you're gonna walk the edge.
Yeah.
seen this morning was a couple squirrels that were running around, and I heard a bunch of turkeys in the back here, but it's been a pretty quiet morning, so we're going to go do a couple drives before the Vikings game, obviously, today, and see if we can't stir something up and maybe get a little bit more shooting. I shot a 7-pointer last night in this same spot. So, I know there's deer traffic moving through here. It's just, nobody's out pushing them around right now. They don't have any reason to really be moving right now. It's about 40 degrees out here today, this morning, compared to yesterday, which was about 25, 26 degrees in the morning yesterday, which got them up and moving a little bit more. So, there's only one thing left to do is we got to go out and find them. Push them out, so hopefully we'll be getting some shooting later. We had some success with the drives that we did yesterday. I ended up shooting a 6-pointer on our first drive we did, and every other drive after that we pretty much got at least a couple shots off, so we've had the opportunities there. The opportunities are there. We had some nice bucks come out from a couple of our drives yesterday, so we'll probably get those spots up again maybe. And then I had a 7-pointer come in last night, sitting right in this exact spot. So, but stay tuned, everybody. We're gonna go do some driving. We're gonna get the GoPro on, and we're gonna see if we can get a little action for you. Stay tuned.
Guys, so we're headed out to the creek right now as we speak. The wind is coming out of the northwest today, which is going to put me in my usual spot, which is fine. We should still see some deer movement. It's peak rut right now today and tomorrow and yesterday, so we should get some deer up and moving. With that wind coming out of the north, it should cool it down a little bit, so we'll be sitting in my usual spot. With that being said, hopefully with that wind moving around, and it'll possibly cool it down, get the deer up and moving, and I don't know, we'll find out how it is tonight and see if we can see a lot of movement. We'll have a little fun. We'll get some shooting tonight, so stay tuned and we'll see you out in the creek. as you can see, we did shoot another nice buck. I hit him in the leg from the first shot, it looks like, and then I hit him again in the gut a couple times, I believe, and he was laying down. He was not moving very far. I was able to track him into some thickets, so me and my brother are going to go out and track him right away in the morning since it is a gut shot. We want to give him at least 10 to 12 hours around there, so we're going to give him a little time to pass, and we'll be out in the morning. I know genuinely the area where he laid down at, so it shouldn't be hard, especially having two guys looking around for him tomorrow. We should be able to find him, especially since I jumped him a couple times as I was tracking him, and he didn't run more than 10 yards and laid back down. So we just want to, instead of chasing him around that creek all night, we're just going to give him some time to pass. And so we'll be out there in the morning. So stay tuned because this hunt continues.
These are all the bucks I found so far in the creek. Yep, believe it or not, that second one in is a buck, and then this last one on the end is a buck as well. Good morning, everybody. So today we're going to go out looking for that buck I gut shot last night. I kind of have a general idea of where it is. I'm bringing my brother out there today. I got my wife coming with me, so we got some more eyes out there looking, and we know the general location of where he is. I mean, he was liver shot from the video we reviewed yesterday. So he was running on three legs as well. So somehow I messed up his front leg, but he was also, like I said, he was liver shot. So it's not like he could have gone very far. So yeah, we're gonna go look at the general location of the last place I saw him right before I jumped him. And we'll just fan out and spread out and see what we can find today. So that's what we're doing right now. So as I said yesterday, this hunt continues. He's laying right there.
You found him?
Yeah, he's right there.
He's right there.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
Let's go, baby. Maybe not as big as I thought, but still a decent buck. There's the exit. Yeah, look at the way he's laying on it. I told you he was in these thickets.
Now we gotta drag him not only out of those thickets, but uphill.
There we go.
thank God he was an easy find, though.
Okay, everybody, this concludes the first episode of Rasmussen Outdoors. We had a nice season ender right here. We had a three-bagger season. This is number three right here. We had to give them a day to die off, but thank you for watching, and this concludes the first episode, so the hunt is over. ¶¶